Erythroblastosis foetalis. Erythroblastosis foetalis, also called hemolytic disease of the newborn. It is a type of anemia in which the red blood cells of the fetus are destroyed by maternal antibodies in an immune response targeted against the fetus. It usually occurs in the fetus but can also occur in the neonate. Knowing the blood group of a woman when she is pregnant is very important. If the mother and the fetus has blood groups which are compatible, then there is no harm. But if the mother and fetus blood groups are not compatible, then the immunity system of mother's body produces antibodies to kill the fetus RBC, which are considered as foreign antigens. As a result, the baby can suffer from severe anemia, brain damage, or even death. There are two types of such incompatible diseases, Rh incompatibility disease and ABO incompatibility disease. Rh incompatibility disease is more dangerous than ABO incompatibility disease. When a mother is Rh negative and fetus is Rh positive, the first baby will not be affected because the mother's immune system does not come in contact with the Rh antigen of the fetus. The mother's immune system comes into contact with the fetal antigen at the time of childbirth. This will cause the production of antibodies of mother. During the second pregnancy, when the Rh negative mother is pregnant with an Rh positive fetus, the antibodies of mother cross the placenta and enter the fetal circulation and attack the fetal RBCs, thereby causing severe hemolytic anemia. The fetal bone marrow reacts to the hemolytic anemia by releasing immature RBCs called erythroblasts into the fetal peripheral circulation, causing erythroblastosis foetalis. Hence, the fetus will develop hemolytic anemia, jaundice, mental retardation due to accumulation of bilirubin in the brain, intrauterine death of fetus. Causes of erythroblastosis foetalis. Incompatibilities in blood type can cause erythroblastosis foetalis. One type of incompatibility happens when mother is Rh negative and baby is Rh positive. ABO incompatibility happens because mother and baby have different major blood types, that is A, B and O are the three major blood types. ABO incompatibility is most common when mother's blood type is O and baby's blood type is A or B. Signs and symptoms. Before your baby is born, there will be increased heart rate, enlarged heart, liver or spleen, swelling of your baby's body. After your baby is born, hemolytic anemia occurs due to the destruction of RBCs. Jaundice, yellowing of baby's skin occurs due to the deposition of bilirubin in the skin. Kernicterus, this occurs due to the deposition of bilirubin in the brain and spinal cord. Hydrops foetalis. This is severe form of disease in the newborns and is characterized by gross edema in the abdominal cavity, heart and lungs. Diagnosis. Collect detailed history of past pregnancies, abortions, miscarriages or any blood transfusions. Before your baby is born, healthcare providers may do any of the following tests. Fetal blood sampling. Collecting baby's blood sample from the umbilical cord. Using ultrasound guidance, a needle is put through your skin into your uterus and into the umbilical cord. The sample is sent to a lab for test. Ultrasound. The ultrasound shows your baby's movement, heart rate and organs and helps to see how fast baby is growing. Amniocentesis. Healthcare providers take a fluid sample by inserting a needle into the amnion using ultrasound guidance. The sample will then be sent to a lab to assess the baby's risk of anemia. This test checks for problems in amniotic fluid such as increased bilirubin level. If the levels are elevated, then intrauterine transfusion with Rh negative blood can be given until premature delivery can be induced. Blood tests. Indirect Coombs test is done on the mother's blood if she is found to be Rh negative during the antenatal visit and the father is Rh positive. Then antibody screening is done to check whether the woman is sensitized or not. The indirect Coombs test is done on a sample of the liquid part of the blood. After your baby is born, the direct Coombs test finds maternal antibodies attached to a baby's red blood cells. Direct Coombs test may be done on a newborn baby with Rh positive blood whose mother has Rh negative blood. Sometimes the baby may develop jaundice after birth in spite of the fact that there is no Rh incompatibility. Under these circumstances, the symptoms can be attributed to ABO incompatibility. However, the symptoms are much milder than in case of Rh incompatibility. Treatment. Blood transfusions. The baby may require blood transfusions before birth in order to treat anemia. Intrauterine blood transfusion is given through the umbilical cord. Phototherapy or light therapy is a treatment where the baby is kept under a yellow light which changes the shape of bilirubin and helps its excretion from the body, which is used to treat jaundice. Eye covers may be used to protect baby's eyes from contact with the light. Preterm delivery. In some situations, the baby may need to be born before its full term. Therefore, when the baby's lungs and heart mature enough for delivery, the doctor may advise delivering the baby preterm. After birth, the baby may need to be given further blood transfusions, intravenous infusions, and mechanical respiratory support. Exchange transfusion. Exchange blood transfusion with Rh negative blood group. This procedure may have to be repeated several times. Immunoglobulins. Intravenous immunoglobulin to neutralize maternal anti-D antibodies. It helps to reduce the need for exchange transfusion and to shorten the length of phototherapy. Prevention. It's prevented by giving anti-D injection to the mother within 48 to 72 hours of the first childbirth or termination of pregnancy due to miscarriage, abortion, or ectopic pregnancy. This will destroy the fetal RBCs which have entered the mother's blood. Thus, it will prevent antibody production in the mother. Complications. Carnic stress, respiratory distress, hepatosplenomegaly, kidney problems, staining of the teeth, hemolytic anemia and edema of the body. Elevated bilirubin can cause hearing loss, brain damage, neutropenia, thrombocytopenia, and cerebral palsy. Thank you.